Hi, I am Michiel Molders and I'm a developer advocate at Swirled Labs. Today, I want to introduce you to NFT token metadata JSON schema version 2. Let's get started. So, one and one, what is HIP-412 and how does it relate to the token metadata JSON schema? So, the HIP-412 specification provides a second version of our token metadata JSON schema. Such a metadata schema allows you to define your NFT metadata in a standardized way. This is important because it makes it easier for NFT tooling to scrape and interpret your NFT metadata. For instance, you want to define attributes for your NFT so NFT explorers can calculate the rarity for each of your NFTs. When every project defines their own way to write down attributes data, it becomes increasingly difficult for NFT tooling to interpret your token metadata. To solve this problem, Swirled Labs has introduced HIP-412, which defines the second version of our token metadata. This standard has been designed to be flexible. It caters use cases ranging from collectible NFTs to tokenized real estate. It's even possible to create non-image NFTs such as documents, videos, music, and 3D models, or even multi-file NFTs. So here you can see the full implementation of our schema. Not all properties are required. There are some recommended properties, and there are also many optional fields. But first, let's take a look at the most minimal implementation of our token metadata. Here you can see a very simple metadata schema, which defines a couple of attributes. Our schema defines that name, image, and type are mandatory. The name is just the name of your NFT. The creator here is optional. It can be your name or a pseudonym. And then we have the description, which describes the NFT. It's also an optional attribute. And then the image field. The image field can both serve as a preview image or the default image for your NFT to ensure cross-platform compatibility. The image should be displayed in wallets and marketplaces by default. Therefore, it's recommended to use a low-resolution image as a preview image to make it easier for NFT tooling to scrape and load your image. You can then mark another image in the files array as a default image for your NFT. I'll show you this in the next example. The type field expects a MIME type. This is a common standard that indicates the format of a file. So for instance, in this example, you can see that the first part is image. So we can expect that the image field is referring to an image file and the extension is a PNG file. And lastly, we have the properties field. It's again an optional field and it is defined as a collection of arbitrary fields, which you can use freely. So it's not allowed to add custom fields to the root of the token metadata. However, if you want to add any kind of additional information like the website, the collection, or the license, you can freely structure this information inside of the properties field. And this is also what makes the standard so flexible and usable for other cases like real estate. For example, you could store all kinds of information about your real estate assets within the properties field. And you could even design your own standard for structuring the real estate metadata within this properties field. So we don't need to create new versions of the metadata standard, but you can create your own sub-schema within the properties field. Further, let's take a look at a couple of the optional fields that HIP-412 introduces under the token metadata V2 schema. As I mentioned before, the image field is now used as a preview image and the high resolution image sits in the files array below. And it's also marked by the isDefault bool, which is set to true. So when a marketplace scrapes your NFT metadata, it knows that it doesn't have, that it can use the image file listed as the preview image and the file listed in the files array as the main file. Notice that we're also using a checksum field. The checksum field is a SHA-256 digest of any kind of file. In this case, it's an image file. And it's a handy trick for browsers to first verify if the data it loads from a URL matches the expected hash. So only if it matches, the image or other types of data will be loaded. It's also possible to define an optional format field, as you can see. It indicates the standard and the version that's being used. So here, in this case, it represents HIP-412, and this represents version 2 of our metadata JSON schema. It makes it a little bit easier for exchanges to also know with which kind of data they're dealing. And lastly, you can localize your NFT and indicate the main language for your token metadata. In this snippet, the main language is English, and it's indicated by a two-letter language code EN. And then you can further define other languages. As you can see in the localis array, it says ES and FR, which means Spanish and French. And then you see a URI. And at the end of the URI, there is a locale in brackets. So this gets replaced by ES and FR. So these files you need to create as well. And they localize your entire metadata file in, for example, Spanish or in French. So if a marketplace wants to support different languages, they can look up if the creator has provided information in different languages. If yes, it should be in the following format using the bracket, so they know how to replace the locale with the correct language tag. And then lastly, let's take a look at the attributes field. This field is optional again, and it's mostly or only used for rarity calculation of collectible NFTs. It follows the OpenSea standard where you have the trade type and you have display types and values. So to quickly explain this, the trade type defines the name of your trade and then the value defines the value. For instance, you can have a trade type clothing, and then you can have values like pants, shirt, or t-shirt. Further, there is also a display type. The display type defines how your value should be displayed. So if a marketplace scrapes, for example, the birth, and it sees date time, it knows that it has to interpret this number as a date. And finally, there is also the possibility to set a max value, which limits the height of a numeric value. So if you want to learn more about the specification, you can read the full specification on our HIPs, subdomain hips.hedera.com, and go to HIP-412. There are also blog posts with examples under Hedera NFT metadata HIP-412. Or you can join our Discord to ask questions. We're happy to help. There will also be a tool which will assist you in validating your NFT metadata. Thank you and see you next time.